Good evening, all right, and welcome to film number 5 of our lockdown series. How fast has that flown by? Apologies for those of you that missed me sort of in my not actual abode, i.e. my car, last week. I was feeling a bit ropey, and so I decided to keep myself actually inside, all right. So apologies for those of you who missed the wonderful interior of my shower bank, okay? But I'm back this week, feeling a lot better. And as you can see, nicely clean shaven and properly, like sort of, you know, I got rid of my unruly old man salt and pepper moustache, which has just got wildly out of control and decided to curb it massively and harshly, I think. Yeah, so welcome to Open Mic for Open Minds with, you know, during the lockdown with Kandu Arts and in association with our good friends at the Revo Lounge in Chippenham, all right, who will we be looking forward to going back to spending some time with when we finally get out of this damn lockdown. But in the meantime, I've got a couple of poems that I'd like to share with you this evening, and I know there's going to be some fantastic acts coming on. Oh, God, my phone.
The year already grows tired, frayed and curling at its edges after the scented deceit of spring. Behind the downpour and way before the sun, this land is thrown into sharp focus. Outlines are tightly drawn, pushing forward a surfeit of reality, detailing where the horizons lie. Struggling with perspective, fresh furrowed fields roll prairie-like towards enclosures erstwhile hidden by mist and time. A white horse, whose neck we once grasped, freed from its fold, blocks my route, challenges, turns, and pushes its way into a leaden sky.
Like the flower that opens to the sky, needs the sun and rain, but it's okay, 'cause everyone can cry when you pull away. Don't turn your your face and hide. You're stronger than you know. It's okay to let it show. 'Cause everyone can cry.
I see great green fields in front of my eyes, yet 'tis out of reach. See glorious sun up above my land, yet I don't feel warmth. The temptation grows, yet I must stand strong as the silence breaks. The infinite ramblings of our great leader, nothing but white static. I see it, I crave it, I seek it now, like a child outside of a glass-doored shop. My time draining, me here idle, oh how I miss her, my loved Mother Nature. Yet I must stand here, in isolation, until the sickness goes.
Sorry about that unwanted intrusion from somebody trying to sell me a new energy package. All right, I'm sure Andy will take care of that. But tonight, I think the first thing I want to do for you is a piece that I think I did it at the first open mic. It's a poison pen letter it's self-explanatory. Okay, some of you may have heard it before. All right, this is one of my poems, which is short enough for me to actually have learnt it, which means that I might be able to get through it without messing it up. But hey, there are no guarantees in life. This is just called Katie. All right, and it goes like this. Toxic hater, media crone, effluent creator, moral-free zone. I'd rather choke on a herringbone and listen to her drone on and on and on and on about the latest victim she's lit upon, battered with a stone, made to feel alone, exposed to the fierce cyclone generated by the spotlight thrown, and at the centre on her shabby media throne, a woman whose talents as yet unknown to anyone without a heart of stone. Thank you. That was short and sweet, wasn't it?
We're all stumbling on unfamiliar ground. Changes in the world, scary but profound. There are two new paths for us to choose. Just remember now, there's so much to
door. Scarf. It has been wrapped around my neck for a while now. I am good at doing it up. It is warm, comforting and soft. It holds my neck and parts of my heart tight and caring, like only a scarf bought by my daughter could.
Take 26 billion. Sun.
trade space to hit the ground and run. Shout it, Paul. Pile your coals for a better run. Household. Save your life as all you ever known, ever owned. Ain't it funny how we went nowhere? Ain't it funny how we went nowhere? Ain't it funny how we went, funny how we went nowhere?
The numbers never really added up, and I'm still waiting for the slip twixt lip and cup. 2% mortality, 100% fear. Looking for an explanation. Nothing's really clear. I stopped watching the news, now full of half lies and half truths, naked propaganda, and worst of all, the grief of ordinary folk turned into news porn. Phone a friend, say hello, write some words that don't spiral darkly to the floor. Order food from friends who cook, and contribute to online events where all can choose to look. Practice social distance, and try to remember the last time I touched and was touched in return. Sorry if that's a bit depressing, but I am a bit depressed, quite frankly. All right, but that doesn't mean that I can't have a laugh. All right, that doesn't mean that I can't sort of shake myself out of my torpor. All right, try to sort of get involved in good stuff. So I'm going to take a second now. Right, because Andy's going to be editing the hell out of this later on. At least I hope he is, otherwise people could see my
meltdowns in public.
Not a honey person, but I'd love to taste your lips. Sweetheart's got a honey kiss. Such a funny person, and she always makes me smile. Sweetheart's got a honey smile. But when the night time comes, she lies in her bed, thinking about all the things she had to say, but she kept locked inside her head. Such a loving person, but her loving went astray. Sweetheart's alone today. Such a confused person, crazy patterns all the time. Sweetheart's got a confused mind. And when the night time comes, she cries in her thinking about all the dreams she had and the things she did instead. Not a honey person, but I'd love to taste your lips. Sweetheart's got a honey kiss. Sweetheart's got a honey kiss. Sweetheart's got a honey kiss. Thank you to Julien, to Manu, to all of the Shanikis, old and new, Davy B, and all your crew. You know it's me. I love you.
Virtual quizzes and time whizzes by. Not. The weather's quite hot, though. Is it still global warming? Bees start swarming and butterflies pass in panic, as the manic life we knew just stops. FaceTime, Messenger, GoTo, Zoom, Cisco and Teams and others fill the room. Framed rectangles of familiar heads on a grid, animated out of sync. Cross-talking, share a file, then wait a while whilst broadband catches up. Pub crawls online, watching Jeremy Vine, doing daily exercise, well, most of the time. DIY list getting shorter as you do the jobs you ought to. Use the time wisely to learn something new. Play the recorder, learn Morse code, speak Hebrew. A global crisis and we introspect on our bubbles. What happens if it all falls to rubble? A bit twee to say loved ones, but it's true. Those around you now and supporting online, and when the time comes to reflect, remember those who reached out to you, not the other way around. Underpaid and overworked for far too long, frontline and support workers for whom we bang the gong every Thursday at 8. The daily debate about the government response, furloughed staff, death rates off the graph. Businesses pause while medicine finds a cure for the cause. But where are the kits for antibody testing? Government and industry innovate, investing. We may emerge with a world in tatters, but a clearer perspective of what really matters. Rally to boost a failing economy, galvanised in tragedy, I becomes we. Working from home and too many gins, social distancing delivers some wins. There are no exams this year for the COVID cohort. School reports support the awarded grades, no retort. Police being coughed at becomes an offence. Meetings and gatherings become virtual events. Loved souls leave, seemingly alone. Their last sight, the face mask, visor and gown that protect the real heroes fulfilling a vocation. Rainbows in windows show the love of the nation. It's here for the foreseeable, this COVID-19, devastating lives, this virus unseen. Stay indoors to save ourselves is not too much to ask, but for some it seems impossible. Park parties, irresponsible. Keep calm in isolation, a collection of bubbles. One nation faced a pandemic through one eye, until we can hug and cry again with those we have missed, and reclaim the lost kiss.
Gives a fuck about an Oxford comma. Seen those English dramas too. They're cruel. And if there's any other way, spell words for me. But me, please do not speak to me their way. Especially when always said that I haven't got all the words for you. Oh, addiction, dripping with disdain through the pain. I always told the truth. Fuck about an Oxford comma. I climbed the dollar solid too. I did. I met the highest llama. Sex and sound fine with me. To me. Grab your passport. It's no treat. Take the chapstick, put it on your lips, crack a smile and adjust my dial. No real boyfriend, unlike other guys. Why would you lie about how much coal you had? Why would you lie about something dumb like that? Why would you lie about anything at all? First the window, then it's to the wall. Little John, he always told the truth.
Darkened soul,
My streets all pop music and gold. All our lives on TV. We switch off and try to sleep. But people get so lonely. I believe everything's out to see. I believe it's the way it should be. I hope you feel the same. Everyone is dying. Stop crying now, here comes the sun. I didn't mean to hurt you. No, no, no. It takes time to see what you've done. So I wean myself off slowly. I believe love is the only one. I deceive, 'cause I'm not that strong. I hope you feel the same. It seems everything's falling apart, but I hope I see the good in you come back again, 'cause I just believed in you.
I want to say thank you to the birds, not the 60s rock band, but the birds for the backing vocals, and Damon Albarn for the lyric and the music. Nice one, brother.
So I just want to take the opportunity now to say massive, massive thank you to everybody that's contributed. All right, and by contribute, I mean, that's if you sent stuff in to us. All right, there's been some beautiful, beautiful poetry. There's been some fantastic original music. There's been some beautiful covers. All right, there's been some lovely tributes, we really, you know, keep those coming, folks. All right, because we are creating a beautiful archive, all right, of social togetherness and commonality of purpose during a very sort of dark time. Nobody knows what's going to happen down the road. Nobody knows, like, sort of how long we're going to be in this situation. All right, but, like, you know, I want to make a commitment to you guys that we're going to come out and we're going to do this every week until we can get back together, all right, in person and have a bloody party, all right? A party of music, a party of humanity, all right? A party of just sheer bloody relief, okay? Because right now that seems quite far away. But, you know, I just want to say thank you to everybody that's contributed to this, the wonderful enterprise that we've got going. All right. And I want to give a special shout out to my man, Andy Byrne, okay, who is, like, sort of gathering the skills to take him forward in the film business, I reckon. All right. Because he's been doing a fabulous job editing and sorting out these films and getting them together online and getting them out there on time, which is no mean feat, I tell you, because I've tried to do it myself and failed miserably. So big ups, Andy. All right, and also to everybody, Ed and Maya, Donna, Jenny, Melanie, Sam, John, Annie. All right, I know I've forgotten people. All right, thank you to Kandu, okay, for just, like, sort of having the wherewithal and the vision, all right, and the commitment to get this done. All right, and I'm really pleased to be a small part of that. All right, so I think that's my lot for tonight. I'm getting my films in quite early this week, so Andy's got plenty of time to get his film sorted out. So I hope you enjoyed the poems, and I hope you've enjoyed the film that we put together for you tonight. All right, and I'm going to say goodnight now before I'm drenched in sweat. Okay, but before I do that, I just want to say cheers. That's naughty having a beer in your car, but sod it. I'm parked outside my house and I'm not going anywhere. There's no police. Has anybody seen a policeman recently? I know I haven't. That's my lot. Bye bye.
Faces.